क्लास एट साइंस एंड लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, द ऑर्गेनिज्म व्हिच कैन नॉट बी सीन, व्हिच कैन नॉट बी सीन विद द विद विद द नेक्ड आई, एंड दीज आर कॉल्ड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. देयर आर सम ऑर्गेनिज्म व्हिच कैन नॉट बी सीन विद द हेल्प ऑफ with the help of naked eye, and these are called microorganism. These organisms are called microbes or microorganism. So what is the example of microorganism and what is the example of microbes? There are four categories of microorganism. First one is bacteria, and second one is fungi, and third is protozoa, and fourth is algae. So what do we mean by microorganism? The organism which cannot be seen by naked eye are called microorganism, and these microorganism are also called microbes. So there are four categories of microorganism. First one is bacteria, second is fungi, third is protozoa, and fourth is algae. And we studied about two activities. In activity 2.1, we take some moist soil and kept it in a beaker. After keeping it in a beaker, we add some water into it. When the soil particles settle down, we observe a drop of water. Under a microscope, there are some tiny particles, and these water and soil are full of tiny organism, and these tiny organism are called microorganism or microbes. As we know, soil and water are made up of small tiny particles, and these particles are these organism are called microorganism or microbes. These are very small in size and they cannot be seen with the unaided eye. And the we have seen fungus that grows on the bread, and these can be seen with the help of magnifying glass, and others cannot be seen with the help of microscope. So that's why these are called microorganism. We studied about that the fungus that grows on the bread can be seen with the help of magnifying glass, and other cannot be seen with the without the help of microscope. And that's why these are called microorganism. As we know, water and as well as soil contains small particles, and these small particles are called microorganism. As we have seen, fungus that grows on the bread, that can be seen with the magnifying glass, and only one microorganism that can be seen with the help of magnifying glass is fungus. So fungus is only one microorganism that can be seen with the help of magnifying glass, and others cannot be seen with the help of microscope, without the help of microscope. So that's why these are called microorganism. And it is divided into four categories: bacteria, fungi, protozoa, and algae. These are divided into four categories. First one is bacteria, second is fungi, third one is protozoa, and fourth is algae. So microorganism is divided into four categories. First one is bacteria, second is fungi, third is protozoa, and fourth one is algae. And there are also other category, viruses. These are also microscopic, but these are different from microbes. And what are the viruses? The common viruses are shown for the following figure. And some diseases like cold, influenza, and cough are caused due to by viruses. And corona is also a virus. And some also serious disease, just like polio, And just like chicken pox, these are also caused by viruses. And there are some also disease, dysentery and malaria. These are caused by protozoa. And typhoid and TB are called bacterial disease. Next is there are some, these are the pictures of bacteria. Figure 2.1 and figure 2.2 is a picture of algae. And these are the picture of protozoa. Amoeba and paramecium are, these are shown in the figure 2.3. And these are the figure of algae. And these are the bread mold. And these penicillin are, these are the fungi. These three are the fungi. First is bacteria, and then is algae, and then is protozoa, and then bread mold, and then is penicillin. These are all fungi. And these are two pictures of viruses. And next topic is, where do microorganisms live? Microorganism can be single cell as well as multicellular. What do you mean by single cell? Those contain only one cell are called single cell, and that contains many cells are called multicell, and these are called multicellular. So where do microorganisms live? Microorganism can be single cell and can be multicellular. They live in all conditions ranging from ice to hot springs and desert to marshy lands. So some microorganism that grows on other organisms while others exist freely. And these are the microorganism and us. There are some microorganisms that are useful for us are called friendly microorganism. Some microorganism can be harmful for us and some microorganism can be helpful for us. The microorganisms that are helpful for us are called friendly microorganisms. The microorganisms that are harmful for us are called harmful microorganisms. Friendly microorganisms are useful microorganisms, and they are used in the preparation of curd, bread, and cake. Microorganisms are used in preparation of curd, bread, and cake. And what is the friendly microorganism and what is their role? Because first is they increase the soil fertility, and they are also used in cleaning up of the environment. What are the uses of microorganism? First one is they are used in cleaning up of environment. How it clean the environment? It converts the organic waste of animals and vegetables into harmless and usable substance by bacteria. So it converts all these waste into a usable substance. So a microorganism are friendly microorganism, and they are also used in cleaning up the environment. So second use is they increase the soil fertility. First one is they are used in cleaning up of the environment. And second is they increase the soil fertility. And third is they are used in preparation of medicines. So there are three uses of microorganism. First one is they are used in for cleaning the environment. And second is they are used in preparation of medicine. Next is they are used to increase soil fertility. So these are the uses of microorganism. Next is how can it helpful for making of curd and bread? Microorganism are also used for making of curd and bread. So next is, as we know, milk is turned into curd by the bacteria. Curd contains several types of microorganisms. Of these, the bacterium lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd. It multiplies in milk and converts into a curd. And bacteria are also involved in the making of cheese, pickles, and some other food items. An important ingredient of rava, idlis, and bhatura is curd. As we know, what are the uses of microorganism? It is used for making of curd and bread. एंड इट कर बिकॉज एज वी नो कर कंटेन्स सेवरल काइंड्स ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड लैक्टोबैसिलस प्रमोट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कर्ड एंड इट मल्टीप्लाइज इन द मिल्क एंड इट कन्वर्ट्स इन टू द कर्ड. सो बैक्टीरिया आर ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व इन द मेकिंग ऑफ चीज पिकल्स एंड सम एनी अदर फूड आइटम. And what are the important ingredient of rava, idlis and bhatura is curd. So microorganism is used for making curd and bread. And lactobacillus is microorganism that involves in the formation of curd. And it grows one by one and it multiplies and convert into the curd. Or and bacteria are also involved in the making of cheese, pickles, and some other food items. And for making bhaturas and idli, then it is also used. Microorganism is also used. Bacteria and yeast are also helpful for the fermentation of rice, idlis, and dosa batter. So we studied about what are the uses of microorganism. First one is they are used for cleaning the environment. And second is they are used to increase soil fertility. And next is they are used for preparation of medicine. Next is they are used for making of curd. Next is they are used for making of bread. And bacteria are also involved in making of cheese, pickles, and some food items. And what is the important ingredient of rava, idlis, and bhatura is curd. And these are the uses of microorganism. So how can we use microorganism? What are the use of microorganism? It can be used for making curd and it can be used for making bread. And when lactobacillus is a bacterium which promote the formation of curd and it multiply in milk and it converts into the curd. And these are also involved in the formation of cheese, pickles, and some food items. And bacteria and yeast are also used for formation of rice, idli, and dosa batter. Next activity is activity 2.3. Yesterday we studied about activity 2.3. First, we will take 1/2 gram flour, just like atta or maida. Firstly, we will take half kilogram flour and we will add some sugar and then we will add some warm water. After mixing it, we will add some yeast powder and we will make it a soft dough. Firstly, we will take 1/2 gram flour and then we will add some sugar and then we will mix it with warm water. After putting some yeast powder, we will make a soft dough. Then what we will observe, then the dough is rising. And this raised maida is shown in the figure 2.6. Firstly, we will take 1/2 gram flour. After when we take 1/2 gram flour and then we will add some sugar and mix with warm water. After mixing with warm water, we will add some small amount of yeast powder and we will make it a soft dough. After mixing it, after adding some yeast powder and this dough will become rice and these are shown in the figure raised maida. When we put some yeast powder and some sugar and some water into atta, then the dough become rice and these are called raised maida. So because as we know, yeast produce a gas carbon dioxide during respiration. And because of carbon dioxide, bubbles of gas will form and it increases its volume. Why maida is raised? Question arises that why maida is raised? Because when we add some yeast into the yeast powder, then after adding some yeast into it, we will see bubbles of gas will form in the dough and it increases its volume. And this is the basis of the use of yeast in baking industry for making bread, pastry, and cakes. And so what is the use of this? Firstly, we will take some 1/2 gram flour and we will add some sugar and we will add some warm water. After adding some sugar and warm water, We will add some small quantity of yeast powder and we will make it a soft dough. After mixing it, this dough will rise. When this will rise, then what will it show? That yeast produce rapidly and produce carbon dioxide during respiration, and these produce a gas, carbon dioxide. When the carbon dioxide gas is produced, the bubbles of gas fill the dough and increase its volume. And this is the use of yeast in baking industry for making bread, pastry, and cake. So what is the use of yeast? Because yeast produces a gas, carbon dioxide. Because of carbon dioxide, this increases the volume of dough and then a raised maida is formed. And it is also used in for baking industry for making bread, pastries, and cake. So what is the role of yeast? Because it produces a gas, carbon dioxide. Because of carbon dioxide, it increases its volume. And when this volume is increases, then maida is raised. And what are the other uses of yeast? Yeast is used for making bread and for making cakes and for making pastries. And next topic is commercial use of microorganism. Today topic is commercial use of microorganism. So there are so many uses of microorganism, and what are the commercial use of microorganism? Microorganism are used for making alcohol and wine. And as we know, these are used for making alcohol and wine, and also used for the acetic acid. As we know, yeast is used for the commercial production of alcohol and wine. For this purpose, yeast is grown on the natural sugar present in grains like wheat, rice, crushed fruit, juices, etc. As we know, what are the uses of microorganism? Microorganism are used for making alcohol and wine and acetic acid. And how can we prepare it? With the help of yeast, we can prepare alcohol and wine. And for this purpose, we grow some yeast on the natural sugar. And this natural sugar is present in wheat and rice and crushed fruit juices. And how can we prepare alcohol? Alcohol is prepared with the help of yeast. And how can it be done? For this purpose, we grow some yeast on the natural sugar present in crushed fruit juice or wheat rices. And how can it be done? This is the smell of alcohol as sugar has been converted into alcohol by yeast. And this process is called fermentation. What do you mean by fermentation? The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol. When we convert all sugar into alcohol, and these can be done with the help of yeast, and this process is called fermentation. When we grow some yeast on the natural sugar, then this sugar is converted into alcohol by the yeast, and this process is called fermentation. And which scientist found it? Louis Pasteur discovered fermentation in 1857. Louis Pasteur was a scientist who discovered fermentation in 1857. So what are the uses of microorganism? Microorganisms are used for large scale for the production of alcohol and for the production of wine and for the production of acetic acid. So there are so many uses of microorganism. First one use is these are used for the production of alcohol, and these are used for the production of wine, and these are also used for the production of acetic acid. And next, it is also used for the production of alcohol and wine. And firstly, we will take how can it convert it into alcohol. Firstly, we will grow some yeast on the natural sugar. And these convert all sugar into alcohol. And then this process is called fermentation. And what is the activity 2.4? Firstly, we will take 500 ml beaker filled with 3x4 with water. एंड वी विल डिजोल्व टू और थ्री स्पून टीस्पूनफुल ऑफ शुगर इन इट. फर्स्टली वी विल टेक 500 ml बीकर फिल्ड विद वॉटर एंड वी विल डिजोल्व टू टू थ्री टीस्पूनफुल ऑफ शुगर इन इनटू इट एंड एड अ हाफ स्पून ऑफ यीस्ट पाउडर टू द शुगर सॉल्यूशन एंड कैप इट इन अ वार्म प्लेस फॉर 4 to 5 hours. नाउ स्मेल द सॉल्यूशन. कैन यू गेट अ स्मेल? देन व्हाट इज द एक्टिविटी? फर्स्टली वी विल टेक 500 ml बीकर and it filled with the water. Firstly, we will take a beaker of 500 ml and it is filled with 3x4 with water. And then we will add 2 to 3 teaspoon of sugar it and add half spoon of yeast powder into it. Firstly, we will take a beaker of water and we will add 2 to 3 spoon of sugar and then we will add a spoon. Then we will add half a spoon of yeast powder to the sugar and we will then keep these all arrangement in a warm place for 4 to 5 hours. Now smell the solution and this is a smell of alcohol as sugar and these has been converted into alcohol by yeast and these all sugar are converted into alcohol by yeast and this process is called fermentation. So how can we prepare alcohol? Firstly, we will take a beaker filled with water and then we will add some sugar into it and then we will add half a teaspoon of yeast powder into the sugar solution. After adding yeast powder kept into the warm place for 2-5 hours, then we will smell these items. Then we will smell the smell of alcohol and because all sugar has been converted into alcohol by the yeast and so this process is called fermentation. And Louis Pasteur is the scientist who discovered fermentation in 1857. So what are the commercial use of microorganism? Microorganisms are used for the making alcohol and acetic acid and wine on the large scale. And this is a very useful use of microorganism. And how can we prepare alcohol? It can be prepared with the help of yeast. Firstly, we will grow some yeast on the natural sugar. And how can it be done? Firstly, we will take a beaker filled with water and then we will add some sugar into it. And after adding sugar, then we will add some yeast powder. And after putting some yeast powder into it, then after adding some yeast powder into it, then kept into a warm place for 4 to 5 hours. Now smell the solution. And after smelling the solution, then we will find the smell of alcohol. Then we will find smell of alcohol as sugar because these has been converted into alcohol by yeast. This process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is known as fermentation. And Louis Pasteur is the scientist who discovered fermentation in 1857. And what do we mean by fermentation? The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is known as fermentation. And Louis Pasteur is the scientist who discovered fermentation in 1857. So this is the scientist Louis Pasteur who discovered fermentation in 1857. And next is what are the medical use of microorganism? Whenever you fall ill till the doctor may give some antibiotic tablets, capsule or injection such as penicillin. The source of these medicine is microorganism. As we know, what are the medicine use of microorganism? Whenever you fall ill, the doctor give you some antibiotic tablets, some injections such as penicillin, and the source of these medicine is microorganism. And these microorganisms kill or stop the growth of disease. And these medicines are called antibiotic. And what are the medical use of microorganism? When you fall ill, डॉक्टर मे गिव अ टैबलेट्स एंड दिस टैबलेट इज एंटीबायोटिक टैबलेट्स एंड दिस कैन बी डन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कैप्सूल एंड दिस कैन बी डन टेकन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इंजेक्शन जस्ट लाइक पेंसिलिन एंड दीज आर फॉर्म फ्रॉम ऑल माइक्रोनिज्म सो फॉर माइक्रोनिज्म आर ऑल्सो यूज फॉर मेकिंग मेडिसिन सो अनदर यूज ऑफ माइक्रोनिज्म इज दीज आर यूज फॉर मेकिंग मेडिसिन सो ऑल एंटीबायोटिक टैबलेट्स सच एज टैबलेट्स ऑफ हेडेक एंड टैबलेट्स ऑफ स्टमक And these are all antibiotic tablets are made from microorganism, and the source of these medicine is a microorganism. And these medicine, as we know, what are antibiotics? How can we it prepared? It can be prepared with the help of microorganism, and the source of these medicine is microorganism. These medicine kill or stop the growth. Such medicine are called antibiotic. These days, a number of antibiotics are being produced from bacteria and fungi. As we know, what are the medical use of microorganism? When you fall ill, the doctor may give you a medicine, and these medicine is called antibiotic tablets. And these can be taken in the form of capsule, and can be taken in the form of injection just like in penicillin and these are all these antibiotics are obtained from all microorganism as we know these medicine kill or stop the growth or disease when we become ill then these stop the growth of microorganism and these micro medicine are called antibiotics and these antibiotic medicine are called antibiotics As we know, these days a number of antibiotics are spread from fungi and bacteria. So, microorganism. When you become ill, the doctor may give you some antibiotic tablets in the form of capsule and penicillin, and the source of these medicine is microorganism. As we know, what are antibiotics? Because these medicine kill or stop the growth of disease causing microorganism. And these medicine are called antibiotics. And what are the medical use of microorganism? As we know, when we became ill, the doctor may give you a medicine, and these medicine is taken in the form of antibiotics. And these are the medical use of microorganism. Produced from microorganism. And these can be taken in the form of either injection, either in the form of capsule, or either in the form of tablets. And so these are called antibiotics. These days, a number of antibiotics are being produced from bacteria and fungi. So these are the medicine, streptomycin, tetracycline, and erythromycin. These are the example of antibiotics. So what are the use of antibiotics? Whenever you fall ill, the doctor give you a medicine, and these medicine is called antibiotic, and these can be taken either in the form of tablets or either in the form of injection, and can be in the form of capsule. So these are produced from bacteria and fungi, and this streptomycin, tetracycline, and these are the example of microorganism. So what are the commercial use of microorganism? These are used for the what are the commercial use of microorganism? माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म आर यूज्ड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ अल्कोहल. दीज आर यूज्ड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ अल्कोहल, वाइन एंड एसिटिक एसिड. तो माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म आर यूज्ड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ अल्कोहल, वाइन एंड एसिटिक एसिड, एंड दीज आर ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एल्कोहल एंड वाइन, एंड दीज आर प्रेजेंट इन द दीज आर यूज इन एंड हाउ कैन वी प्रिपेयर दिस एल्कोहल. फर्स्टली वी विल टेक अ बीकर फुली फिल्ड विद वॉटर, एंड देन वी विल एड सम शुगर इन टू इट. आफ्टर एडिंग sugar into it, we will add some yeast powder into it, then cap it into the warm place for 4 to 5 hours. Now what we will get obtained, and then these will convert into the sugar, and the process of conversion, this all converted into alcohol, and the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol, then this is called fermentation. And this is the fermentation process. The process of conversion of water sugar into alcohol is called fermentation. And what are the medical use of microorganism? And what are antibiotics? When you become ill, the doctor give you a medicine, and this medicine is antibiotics. And antibiotics are made from microorganism. And these can be taken either in the form of capsule or injection or in the form of penicillin. So these are antibiotics. So there are so many antibiotics used, and these are all prepared from microorganism. So there are so many antibiotics, just like streptomycin, tetracycline, and erythromycin. These are the example of microorganism. And these are the example of antibiotics. So in 1929, Alexandra Fleming was working on a culture of disease-causing bacteria. Suddenly, he found that the spores of little green mold in one of his culture plates, he observed the presence of mold, prevented the growth of bacteria. In fact, it is also called many of these bacteria. From these, the mold penicillin was prepared. As we know, in 1929, Alexandra Fleming was working on a tea culture of disease bacteria. Then he found that a little green mold in the culture plate. He observed the presence of mold, and in fact, it is also killed many of these bacteria. From these, penicillin was prepared. So who will find the penicillin? In 1929, Alexandra Fleming found the penicillin. So in 1929, Alexandra Fleming was working on a tissue of, on a culture of disease, and these are from these the mold penicillin was prepared. So who discovered fermentation? Louis Pasteur discovered fermentation in 1857, and Alexandra Fleming discovered penicillin in 1929. And how penicillin was prepared? In 1929, the scientist Alexandra Fleming was working an experiment about the tissue culture of disease causing bacteria. Suddenly, he found that there are small green molds in the culture plate. And he observed that the presence of mold prevented the growth of bacteria. In fact, it is also killed many of these bacteria, and from these mold penicillin was prepared. And how penicillin was prepared? In 1929, Alexandra Fleming was working on an experiment about culture plates. Then he found a mold, prevented the growth of bacteria. And then, in fact, it is also killed many of these bacteria, and then penicillin was prepared. So these are the micro medicine use of microorganism. And next is for the growing microorganism as well as to cure disease. So so microorganism has very useful effects. What are the uses of microorganism? Microorganism are used for the for making alcohol and microorganisms are used for making antibiotics and microorganisms are used for increasing the soil fertility and microorganisms are used for making curd and bread and microorganisms are used in increasing soil and fertility and these are used for conversion of organic waste into harmless and useful substance by the bacteria and they are also used in agriculture. They are used to prepare wine and alcohol and they are also used for making antibiotics and what are the other use of antibiotics? Antibiotics are also used to cure disease and these microorganisms has also harmless effects. And in the next topic, we will study about the topic vaccine and we will study it later and how it increases the soil fertility and how it cleans the environment and what are the harmful microorganisms and what are the pathogens and what are the communicable disease and what are the carriers. And these are